Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm so excited because I'm going to be showing you my 2018 makeup, skincare, haircare favorites. So like 2018 has been really a very good year for me because I started my channel around 2017 December. So I had a lot of new products to, you know, experience and show you guys on my channel. So 2018 has given me a lot more exposure to a lot of makeup products which are affordable, which are high end, which are you know, super duper cool when it comes to the worth the products are. So there are a lot of things that we need to really discuss, and I have some favorites which I have been loving this 2018 completely. So I have some products starting from the skincare, so that I cover up skincare, makeup, hair care together. If you want to watch what are all those, then please keep on watching and give this video a thumbs up if you really enjoyed. And if you also have some of the products which I showed you on this video as your favorites as well. So let's get right into the video. But if you haven't subscribed my channel, please go and hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon next to it, which means a lot to me, and give this video a thumbs up, and let's meet in the 2019. So firstly, I'm going to be starting with skincare basically, because skincare is very important when it comes to makeup for me, because when your makeup wants to be looking flawless, then your skincare regime has to be really very good. So I follow very good skincare. Even if I'm very very tired, if I'm very lazy, I do follow a perfect CTM routine. At least I, you know, follow a cleansing and a moisturizing routine if I, you know, skip the toner routine. So this is how it goes, and I have some products which are really really, you know, good for your skin, and also you know, which really worked on my skin personally, and which I really like and recommend for the oily skin category. So I have two recommendations for the cleansers or face washes, I would say. The first face wash I'm going to be showing you is the Ozori. It is called the Volcanic Minerals Africa Ozori Vitamin E Face Wash. This is a paraben-free, cruelty-free product. And as you can see, I have like half a bottle already completed, and this is my second bottle. This is priced for 99 rupees. It has an amazing fragrance to it. It does not dry up my skin. It just takes off all of that, you know, dirt on your skin, makeup on your skin. And I have already specified this face wash in one of my favorites video. I think May or April, I don't know. So I really love the product, and it has a very refreshing scent to it. So if I'm very tired or hectic the whole day, this gives me a very good relief from all of those. So the next face wash is by M Caffeine. It's the Neem Caffeine face wash, and this one has very good ingredients. Both of these has, you know, vitamin E into it as a base ingredient, which I really like, and both of them are paraben free, cruelty free products. And this one is you know, very good for acne prone skin also, and it has a very good scent as all of the M Caffeine products have. So give this a try, and this is for 50 ml, and this is for 100 ml. So moving on to scrubs, I really love the you know, Chronocare Polish the Blemish Face Scrub. This also has a light, or I would say it is having that, you know, a sensitiveness when you apply it on your skin, that if you take a lot of quantity and apply or you scrub on your skin, you can feel that irritation. But if you take a little amount, little quantity, I think this is an amazing product, because it just smooths out your skin after your face wash, after you scrub. So I really love this, and this is also having a very good kind of an Ayurvedic kind of a feel, which I like. And this one is priced for rupees 460 rupees, and I think I got it in my Glamigo box last year, and I really loved it, because I think all of the Chronocare products are really really very good. So this one is also very very good. This one is sulfate, mineral oil, paraben, silicone, and fragrance free, and I think this is for all skin types. So moving on to you know, masks or like face packs, or you know, ready-made face pack, because I personally feel DIY face packs work really well for me. But apart from that, if you ask me, I would suggest this M Caffeine Choco Caffeine Glow face pack. So this is for oily skin basically. So I really love this, and it has minute scrubbing particles. So once you apply the face pack, and once you wash it, you can lightly scrub here and there, so that your excess oil or excess dirt comes out. And this one also I got in some of my subscription box, I think in Glamigo, I'm not sure. If you are someone from the oily skin, give this a try because it just, you know, controls all of your oiliness and cleans all of your pores. So give this a try. So moving on to sheet masks. I have two sheet masks which are not very popular in the market. One is the Mirabel sheet mask and one is Monsup. I think Monsup is very popular, but the Mirabel one, I think it is very underrated because I don't see many of the YouTubers doing any reviews about this. I see very, very limited people doing reviews about this, but this is also looking and working really, really very good. I can compare it with the Face Shop, you know, sheet mask. They are similar, mostly similar. So I really like the Mirabel Cosmetics Korea sheet mask. So I think I bought the blueberry variant, the cucumber variant, and aloe vera variant. I liked all three, and it was really very good. And the essence stays for about 1 hour, I'll say, on my skin. I think most of the sheet masks are like that. So I like both of these, and they are very good recommendations if you have very tired skin, if you have very pigmented skin, because you know your pigmented skin, your tired skin, or your acne prone skin requires a lot of attention when it comes to skincare. So please use sheet masks in your skincare routine because it's very good, because we don't really get time to, you know, make up all of the DIY face packs at home. So this comes handy and it's very safe. So moving on to toners, I have two toners which I like always. Like, it's not about the years, it's about my personal favorites. One is the Himalaya Herbals Refreshing and Clarifying Toner, which I have been using like years now. And this one is like my favorite in the 2018. But I always have a, you know, backup of this product because I feel that this one gives me a more refreshing feel after I, you know, tone my face. And this one is alcohol free and it's for all skin types. And this one is very affordable. I think it's for 80 rupees. And this one is priced for rupees 175 rupees, and you get same quantity. I guess both of them have the same quantity. And this one is called the Bio Cucumber Pore Tightening Toner with Himalayan Waters. This is for normal to oily. So moving on to sunscreen, which is very, very important in your skincare, your makeup and everything. I'm talking about the Lotus Safe Sun UV Screen Matte Gel. So this is a mattifying sunscreen. It does not have any white cast, which I really loved. And I you know, discovered this product only in 2018. This has an SPF of 50, so I don't think you really need to, you know, reapply every 2 hours or something like that. So I think this is very, very good, and it's specially made for normal to oily skin. And this one is priced at 295, and you get 50 grams, I guess, 50 grams or 100 grams. Yeah, 50 grams of the product. So when it comes to moisturizers, I always love my Face Shop moisturizers. But apart from that, in the year 2018, I love the Plum Green Tea Mattifying Moisturizer and the M Caffeine Silver Caffeine Glow Gel. Both of these are amazing. They work really on my, really well on my skin, and also they are mattifying. So I really love that. This, you know, claims to be mattifying. This does not claims to be mattifying, but this one, you know, very you know, good, and you know, mattifies your skin very well. I think I have recently put up a top 5 moisturizer video, so if you want to watch that video, go and watch that. That's basically for the oily skin category, and this just takes 2 or 3 seconds to just sweep in your skin, but this is very good and it has a very good scent. And my Plum always is very handy, very travel friendly, and works really well. Keeps you hydrated. Your skin does not look dry at all. This is very good. So moving on to makeup, we have a lot of things to talk. So I personally, you know, discovered a lot of makeup products in the year 2018. So I'm going to be sharing all of that and my favorites from what all I discovered. So the first thing we are going to be talking is about primers, and I'm going to be talking about the affordable range here. So I have two primers from the affordable range. One is the Blue Heaven primer. This is called the Perfect Makeup Base Studio Perfection Oil Free Non-Greasy Primer, and this one is called the Stay Quirky Primer. Many of the YouTubers told that this one is like a perfect dupe of the Kalabar primer, and this one is very, very good. Both of these have that silicone-y effect, and you know, I do not have a lot of pores, but I have very, very tiny pores, you know, they are starting to emerge from the sides of my nose and my forehead. So I use both of these primers regularly, I would say, like whenever I wear a lot of makeup, I will go for these both, and they are quite affordable. This one is for 300 and I think this one is for 450. So, but you get always this on offer. So you can get this from purple.com, and this one I think is available on Nykaa, Amazon, Tufts and Lashes, many other places. I think Blue Heaven itself has a website where you can get it. Get there, just give this a try. I have a separate video on the complete you know, review of Blue Heaven, and I'll be soon making a video of the Stay Quirky primer, so watch out. So once the primers are completed, we are going to go in for our base. So I have like so many products which I totally loved in the 2018. So I have three foundations here. Two foundations are matte because I have oily skin, and I don't like, you know, satiny finish or dewy finish. I just like matte, not flat, matte finishes. So I dropped the foundation. So I have two matte foundations which I totally love after the Maybelline Fit Me. Maybelline Fit Me, I think I've been using that from the day it got launched. So that is like my 2017-16 favorites. So I'm talking about the L'Oreal Matte Magic 12 Hours Bright Matte Foundation, and I'm in the shade G3, and I don't know how much this is priced now because there's no pricing at the back. This one is really very good, and I think this was my first matte after the Maybelline Fit Me foundation. This is little more matte when compared to the Maybelline Fit Me. Maybelline Fit Me gives you a very natural look, but this one gives you a very mattifying look, and I really love that. And also, you know, it has a very good coverage. It has medium to high coverage. And coming to my next foundation, which I got recently, and which I was like to buy from May, June, I think. I was like eager to buy this foundation from May or June, but I was really unsure of the shade. So I just went to a store after the store got, you know, launched in Chennai. I'm talking about the MAC HD Liquid Foundation. This is in the shade 030, and I'm totally in love with this. It's been like a month now, but I've been using this mostly, so I really love the foundation. It's not like completely matte, it is having a very good natural finish. It gives you a medium to high coverage, and it's quite buildable and does not have any cakiness. I have a separate review video of that. I'll be linking that on my screen. And this one is for 875 rupees now, but this was like 795 when it was launched. So moving on to next foundation, which is a satin finish and yet an affordable foundation, was like this Olivia Liquid Foundation. I don't know why I was so obsessed with this when this was so much talked on YouTube. I just wanted to buy this. I had no other choice. I didn't, you know, see or search for other foundations which are drugstore, which are like costly. I just wanted to buy this foundation. I don't know why, because I think you know, it has very good coverage and it has satin finish, which does not suit my skin type so much, but I liked it. You know, it's very it's liquidy in consistency, and it's very good on skin, and it gives you a very good coverage. And I have a complete review of this foundation, so if you want to buy or if you want to see how this works, then go and watch my review video. I'll be linking that. And this one is priced for just 100 rupees, and you get it in limited stores. That is one of the issue, like you get it on Cuffs and Lashes online and Jyoti Jia store, I guess, and I don't know. I'll collect that information and put it on the description if I can. So that's all about the foundations which I liked in the 2018. So moving on to concealers, I have a lot of concealers to show you guys, because I loved this year of concealers, because I, you know, I got to know many concealer brands which really worked. And I'm going to be showing you my first concealer which I picked and which I loved after my Maybelline Fit Me concealer. So I'm going to be talking about the LA Girl Pro Conceal. This is in the shade orange. This is a corrector and not a concealer, but I love the formula of this, and I'm trying to buy a perfect shade because I'm very confused between creamy beige and pure beige till now. And as I have a lot of concealers, I just want to save my money. And I love this for, you know, the pigmentation, and whenever I want to hide a lot of dark circles, and whenever I finish my night shift, I look so bad. So I use that, this one for that, and I think this one is priced for 595 rupees, and you get a lot of shades. So I'll be linking that in my description, so check that out. Next concealer is like my favorite concealer because I was a very big fan of Cordlista, and she used to always have this concealer. I don't know why. I have not seen her use a lot of Maybelline Fit Me, but I have seen a lot to use a lot of L'Oreal True Match concealer, and this is in the shade light to medium N45. So this is how it looks, but this is a perfect concealer for me. Like, it can conceal my dark circles very well. It matches that, and I use it for spot concealing. I really love the product. It's very creamy, it's very easily blendable. So give this a try if you're someone from my skin tone. This is an amazing product and does not crease so much when compared to other concealers. This is a lovely product. Then coming to my affordable concealers, which I really loved, are these two concealers, which is, I think, for 100 rupees. This one is the NY Bay concealer. This is a stick concealer, and you can use it as a foundation stick or a concealer stick or a contour stick if you pick a darker shade. And this is how it looks. This is how it looks. And this one is a perfect highlighting color for me, and I think this is in the shade Corne Island Caramel 4. This one is for 115 rupees, 115 rupees, but I got it for 99 rupees, I guess. Next is the Olivia Pan Stick, which is also my obsession, because I was so crazy. I don't know why. Even now I cannot believe why I was so crazy. And this product gives you full coverage, and I'm in the shade Touch and Glow. I use it as my eyeshadow primer, under eye area highlighter or something like that. And if I use it as my full face, I think I have done a full face with this. It looks very, very light on my skin and gives me that ghost effect. So I didn't use that, but many say that this is their shade, like whoever belong to my skin tone, that is the reason I got it. But it is not my skin tone, it's very lighter. I have a complete review of this foundation stick, concealer stick as well on my channel, so please go and watch that if you want to buy this product. This is priced for 120 rupees, and you mostly get it like cups and lashes, like that. So moving on to compact, I love the L'Oreal Matte Magic compact powder. I didn't buy any other compact powder in this year. I think I bought the Focalure one, but I didn't like it so much, and I bought the Itex one, which is quite okay. But I love this, and this was like my all-time favorite. Like, whenever I do a video or whenever I go out to have a very good makeup look or something, I always set this with my set my base with this. And also I use it on a daily wear, because I don't really wear a lot of foundation or BB cream on a daily basis. But I use this compact because it gives you a very good coverage, and it comes with a mirror inside, which you can use it on the go, and you have different shades. And I think I'm in the shade N6 Nude Honey, I guess. I think I'm literally different shades in the foundation and on the compact. And I think the compact is like a half a shade lighter to me, but it's okay because it sometimes oxidizes. So I really love it, and I think this is my third or fourth pack. I think third pack. I have been restocking this powder. I really love. So moving on to blushes, I always like the Maybelline blushes, but in the 2018 I discovered two brands which were like very uncommon to me before I started a YouTube channel. Was these two brands. One is called the Miss Claire. I think Miss Claire is now very popular because of the lip creams. And the another one is called the In Color Glimmer Blushes. So this is like a baked blush. You can see how fab the color is. And this has a very good sheen to it, which you can use it as a highlighter if you want, or you can use it as an eyeshadow. And the shade called 33, and I have another shade in Miss Claire blush. This is very good for my skin. Basically, it looks very natural on my cheeks. If I take a very little amount, if I take a large quantity, then it looks like a clown. But I love this, and I have another shade which is like broken, so I don't want to show that out. And I have two blushes which I really loved in 2018. So moving on to highlighters, highlighters are very, very important, you know, in makeup, just to bring out that natural kind of a glow on your face. So I'm talking about the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder, and this is in the shade Precious Petals, and I think this has been like a very good hit in the Indian market, and this is how it looks. As you can see, I've used a lot of product. And next comes the In Color Baking Highlighter. This has a very golden undertone to it, and this has a very peach undertone to it, as you can see. And this way, this one goes a long way. It has very good pigment, as you can see. It's little powdery, as you can see, but it's very good on skin. And this one is like butter. See, can you see that? Already I have it on my skin. So moving on to contour sticks, I have two contour sticks with me. One is from NYB and one is by Focalur. The NYB one is like very, very natural for me. I think this is in the shade Toffee for the Harlem Dance. So this one is like a perfect you know, contour shade for me when I want it very natural. But this one is little darker, but I like it because when you want to, you know, really, really you know, showcase your, you know, features, or, you know, your what to say, your cuttings, then this one is very good. And I think this one is in the shade 03 Coffee, and this one is for 300 rupees and this is for 115 rupees. I don't know like how much quantity it carries. This one is 6 grams, but this one I don't think, yeah, this is for 4.2 grams and this one is 6 grams. So I really love the packaging because you know, they are very, very compact and they're black in color, matte black in color, and they really work well and it's very easy to blend on your skin. So give these a try if you really want to try out some new and affordable contour sticks. So moving on to eyeliners, I really love the eyeliners from Stay Quirky and NYB. Both of these are available on purple.com, and I really love both of these because they are matte and they are very sleek in packaging and very affordable. I think I have two you know, backups of this NYB, I guess. Not two, one. And I really love this when compared to the Stay Quirky because it's very, very easy to apply, and you know, it really stays for a very good amount of time. I have a complete review of this product on my channel, and you know, it's very, very difficult to remove actually once you, you know, come take off your makeup. So 100% waterproof, and this one is also very good, and it comes in a variety of shades. So I'll be dropping all of that on my description, so you can go and buy other shades like bronze, blue, green, like that. So I'm going to be experiencing and trying new shades from this range, so in the 2019, so I'll be letting you know about that. So when it comes to kajals, I love the plum kajal so much. I don't know, it's like it has become small. I have to buy a new one. I really love how it works and, you know, how it glides on your skin, and I don't feel any irritation or something. And this one is called the Nature Studio All Day Wear Cold Kajal. It's very you know, friendly because I think the sharpening one is more very hygienic for your eyes, because I personally had an infection, as you can see here, it's still there. So this one is smudge proof, all day waterproof, preservative free and vegan friendly, and this one is a paraben free, cruelty free product. And there's another variant in this also. So this one is priced for 395 rupees, and I think this is a very good product. So if you see any sale or something on Nykaa for this product, just grab it because I think you have to try this out. It's very good. And moving on to the next, this is a colored you know, eye pencil. It's called the Glimmer Stick for lips and eyes, but I basically use it for my eyes. As you can see, I have it right now on my eyes as a kajal. This is from Cameo. This one is just for 30 rupees, but it gives you a very good pigmentation. See how it is pigmented, and it's a very beautiful color. It's a greenish color, and I really love that. It has an aqua greenish kind of a color, and very, very blendable, very creamy. So you can use it on your eyelids, and you can, you know, bring out a lot of eyeshadows. And moving on to eyebrow pencils and eyebrow kits. I have a lot of products to show you guys because I love all of the products I'm going to be showing you. Most favorite and most awaited product is this Miss Claire Eyebrow Cake. It's called Eyebrow Cake, and it has four different colors with a very good spoolie and angular brush here, which is very, very handy for application when you're on the go or traveling. I really love the colors because I think you can, you know, really share it with some of your relatives or friends when you're on the go and if they really need an eyebrow tutorial. So I really love the colors, and this one is priced for $4.95, I guess. And whenever I see this on Nykaa, it was always out of stock. So I just picked it during the Nykaa Pink sale. So I've already told that twice or thrice in that haul video itself. So moving on to my next eyebrow favorite is the Miss Claire Eyebrow Pencil. I've seen many of the celebrities here in Chennai using this product, which I was totally shocked because I don't feel that a 65 rupees eyebrow pencil must be there in their handbags. So whenever I see a lot of handbag, what's in my handbag videos, I was like totally amazed and totally shocked because they did have this Miss Claire eyebrow pencil. And this one comes with a brush which you can tame your eyebrows, and this one is very creamy and looks completely natural on your eyebrows. And I love this for my everyday wear. And moving on to my next favorite, which is my Maybelline Duo Shaper. I don't use it too much because I feel that it will get over soon, but I love it because on one side you have the pencil or whatever you call it, and the other side you have the powder where you can fill your gaps in your eyebrows. And this one is priced for ₹300 or something, but I always get things like this in offer, and I really love this product because this was my first eyebrow product when I started my eyebrow makeup or something. I really love this because it worked great on my skin, completely looked natural, and I think I bought this product because it's Shreya Jain, and I think she owns this. So moving on to mascaras, I love the Maybelline New York Close and Volume Express Mascara, and I love the Focalure Mascara. This is like, I think, very easy to apply on your lower lashes, and because of the brush, it's very compact and sleek, and it gives you very good fuller lashes, volume lashes. And I love the Maybelline Colossal. I think this is my second or third pack. I really love both of these, and if you want to, you know, give your lashes a very good volume, then you can try the Volume Express Mascara and the Focalure one, because this Focalure one is quite an affordable thing. It's for $300, I guess, and this one I think it's for $425. So when it comes to eyeshadow palettes, I have 5 eyeshadow palettes with me which I liked in the year 2018. So first eyeshadow palette is this Wet n Wild eyeshadow palette. I have a complete swatch video, I guess, on my channel, and I really love the colors. This is in the shade Rose in the Air. I'm not going to be elaborating because I think the video is quite long. Moving on to my next eyeshadow palette, this is completely a neutral palette which is from Focalure, and this was my first pick from Focalure and I really loved it. This is in the shade 03. And moving on to the next eyeshadow palette from Focalure is the 12 color portable eyeshadow palette, which I have a complete swatch video on my channel as well. So this is having a very beautiful colors, which is having matte colors, and they have a dual ended brush with it, and the colors are totally flattering, and it comes with a mirror, and I love the color of the package basically. And moving on to the next eyeshadow palette is the Artisti Collection by Shivana Colors. This is totally flattering and it has neutral shades, and I love the shades. These both shades I really love. They are very pigmented. And comes the last eyeshadow palette which I recently bought and I totally loved, is the LA Colors Sweet 16 color eyeshadow palette, and this is in the shade Playful. This is in the shade, the Shivana one is in the shade 01. I'll be mentioning all of that on my description box as well. I have a bunch of lipsticks which I really love and I've been using like on daily basis basically. So I have very affordable products, I would say, when it comes to lipsticks. So the first lipstick brand which I'm going to be talking is the L18 ColourPop's matte lipstick. I have two shades right here, which is called, one is called Pink Kiss, another one is called Mauve Date. I like both of the colors. Pink Kiss is very pinkish nude kind of a color and is an everyday wear color, and I totally love the color, and this is how the color looks. I've already shown this somewhere in one of my videos, I guess, and I love the formula of these lipsticks. They are not drying and they are at matte lipsticks, and they stay for a very good amount of time. They do transfer, but they are very good on your lips. So I totally love, and they are priced at just 100 rupees and you get in many offline stores as well. So give these a try because they have a wide range of shade range. Next, moving on to my favorite lipstick. This one is from Stay Quirky. I really love the color. This is called Want to Get Messy 24. This is a soft matte lipstick and this was my first pick from the brand Stay Quirky, and this is my first lipstick from them. I really love the color. This is a pinkish nude color and I usually go for this color when I want to give my makeup a very natural and very very simple look. I have the lipstick on my lips right now and it has already gone lightly. This has a very semi matte finish and looks great on lips, but this one is priced for about 250, I guess. I'll be mentioning all that on my description, so do check that out. And I have two lipsticks from Lakme. One is the Lakme Lip Pout, Lakme Absolute Lip Pout Matte, and this one is in the shade Victorian Rose, and I totally love the color because it's a very very flattering pink color and very suitable for any weddings or any parties because it gives you a very very good look to your makeup. And my next pick is from the Masaba collection. This one is the Lakme Absolute Lip Pout Masaba Lips and this is in the shade Caramel Toffee. This is a perfect nude for the Indian skin tone. I love the color and this is very matte. I feel sometimes this one dries my lips so much. So please use a lip balm if you have chapped dry lips. Next is my favorite brand, that is the Miss Claire soft matte lip cream. This is like it transfers very very little bit, but I love the color. This is in the shade 05 and I'm going to be buying other colors very soon because I love the formula and I love the color basically and love the formula. It stays very well on the lips and does not give your lips any dry chappiness. It is great for the Indian skin tone girls. And my last lipstick is from Blue Heaven. This one is a non-transfer proof lipstick. This one is in the shade Raspberry Love. This is a flattering pinkish red color. It looks great on any Indian traditional outfit. If you just have this, you will look very very good. If you have just your earrings and your necklace and no makeup, and this lipstick will go really well. Next makeup fixer is a very affordable makeup fixer and I love this. I have finished two bottles of this product. This is the SFR All Day Pro Setting HD High Definition Setting Spray, Long Lasting and Matte Finish. This gives you a very good matte finish and is quite affordable. So if you are someone from the beginner category, then you can give this a try. I think this one is priced for 130 or 150. You can get this from Cuffs and Lashes or Jyoti Jia store. I'll be linking that on my description as well. I think I've covered up everything whichever I thought I have to really tell you guys about makeup, skincare and everything. So I think this was a really big video, but it's the year is going to end, so I think it's okay. And also I feel that you guys found it to be helpful because I have shared a lot of affordable stuff also in this video. So if you like this video and found it to be helpful, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. And I'll be catching you very soon in the next year. Till then, take care, bye bye, and don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up.